Just heading for world fame, performing live in the programme tonight. The pianist Yundi, already iconic in his native China, and the remarkable Russian singer Julia Lezhneva, who's already sung at Salzburg with Domingo. Plus 70 not out, still at the top of his game, candles lit later for Sir John Eliot Gardner. Got ferried off with Yokes and God going up in exultation from Bach's BWV 43. The Monteverdi Choir, English Baroque soloist, and Sir John Eliot Gardner. Well, exultation there was aplenty at Easter Monday here on Radio 3 and in the Royal Albert Hall in the Bach Marathon with Sir John celebrating the beginning of his 70th birthday. The celebrations continue here on In Tune after 6 o'clock. But now, my first guest, well, his first passion was for the accordion. Fortunately for us, Yundi Lis switched to the piano when he was 7. At 18, he was the youngest and the first Chinese winner of the Chopin International Piano Competition, is regarded now as one of his great exponents. But he says now he's ready for Beethoven, and I'm delighted to say he's here to prove it. Welcome back. It's great to have you with us.
Hi.
How long has it taken you to get to the pinnacle of Beethoven? Because you've waited a while.
Well, it's a natural, it's automatic. So from the Chopin to Beethoven, and also those three pieces, which I just did a recording last year, and Pathetic, Appassionata, and Moonlight, those are my favorite.
Yeah. Well, I think you're going to play the opening of the Moonlight now. Not a term that Beethoven gave, but I think Rellstab said it was all about a boat gliding at moonlight on Lake Lucerne. But we don't need the images, really. I think there's probably enough in the music, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yundi, thank you very much indeed. You make your way across the vast expanse of the parquet, the gleaming ebony. Yundi, live in the studio with Beethoven. Thank you very much indeed, Yundi, playing the opening of the Piano Sonata No. 14 by Beethoven, The Moonlight, so familiar to everyone, and yet never cliched, absolutely not. So Beethoven is a sort of recent addition to the gods. Before we go back to Beethoven, Chopin is someone, of course, you were so celebrated for in winning the International Chopin Competition, getting the Gloria Artis, the great medal from the Polish government. I think you said something very interesting about Chopin, that there was a connection with Chinese culture because there was a certain Eastern restraint in his music.
Oh yes, I think because there's some great poem in China, and we're also learning a lot of poem when we are in school. So those things, I think, especially Chopin's music, very poetic, in poetic side, and those, I think, are very related to Chopin, I think.
Do you find any Eastern sensibility in Beethoven?
Beethoven is very, you know, the music is very large structure, and of course it's very passionate as a personality from Beethoven himself, and also a lot of energy and strong, and in his mind always a lot of hope, and also I think that's it's kind of human, you know, the thoughts, yeah.
I mean, coming to Beethoven later, do you feel you have to maybe be a little bit more aware of the problems in the world and the great struggle of humanity before you come to a titan like Beethoven?
It's different, I think, character. I think Beethoven, and also, of course, there are a lot of music from Beethoven, and they're all quite different. Some music from earlier Beethoven, maybe later, is also a different character himself. But specific, like Moonlight Sonata or Pathetic and Appassionata is also related. I think he's come to, you know, connect to the romantic area side.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you're involved in practical humanity, if you like, as an ambassador for the Red Cross in China. What does that involve? Is it merely trying to reach people through music, or is it more than that?
I think more than that. I think also now in China, a lot of, you know, the children study piano, and because also...
A lot.
I mean, millions. More than 50,000. No, 50,000 million, let's say. 50 million.
50 million.
Yeah, 50 million.
Well,
yeah.
Okay, that's a lot. That's more than a lot.
Yeah, 50 million. Right.
Are they all hoping to be number one like you?
I think not all, but there are all things. The music training is very important, and they want to their, especially the family, they want to their children to have a great, you know, education.
Yeah.
I see.
But it's interesting if you look at the influence of Western music in China, the early 17th century when the Jesuits came, obviously hoping to convert everyone and give a clavichord to the emperor, and then we had refugees after the Bolshevik Revolution, then suddenly shut down, Cultural Revolution, absolutely nothing. Was there much loss there, or have people managed to find their way back to appreciation of it?
So for my generation, I think we didn't feel that because... So maybe after 80s generation, so we are quite lucky because we all live in atmosphere, timing, I think. So that also gives a lot of a challenge and a chance to develop. And even we know last 10 years or last 30 years, China have been very quick develop. And in each different area, and we feel very excited. And for the future, even for our generation.
Yeah. Well, it's certainly much more open, and you're all going forth more, and there are so many more influences.
I mean, more communication, and a lot of now in China, a lot of concert hall have been built, and compared before, 10 years ago, there are not so many places that we can go for lesson concerts, and also now many artists. Musicians, they all have chance also to visit to China to performing, and also good for the audience who start to understand and to know what is the music and classical music.
Yes, well, as long as we have ambassadors like you, we'll be on the right track. It's wonderful to hear. My dad, when you started off, you were Yundi Lee, but you're just Yundi now. Is that easier?
since a few years ago, I think. Yeah. But I think for the Western...
I'll be able to say I knew him when he was Yundi Lee, you know, before he became a one-name artist, international superstar.
Well, I think for me, it's just a, I like people call me Yundi, so it's more feel more close.
Good. Well, we're going to play the end of the Appassionata Sonata from your latest CD. We're allowing you to sit this one out because you actually hurt your finger yesterday. I'm a bit worried about this. Is it
I
all
mean,
right?
A few days ago, I was just crashed the scrap. So and now it's and just see doctor a few hours ago and take medicine and probably will be better tomorrow.
Good. Now, I don't want to alarm anybody. All your fans will be sending you in magical remedies if you're not careful. But he's fine. He's on the mend. It'll be absolutely brilliant. Royal Festival Hall in London tomorrow, and then I think St George's in Liverpool on Friday. Yundi, thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.